So hey, what's up mga Kotex? It's me, Ate Mariel, at welcome sa Koday News, where learning is the name of the game. So kung bago ka pa lamang sa aming YouTube channel, i-click mo na subscribe, like, and share button para maging updated ka sa aming mga videos. So samahan natin si Super K sa panibagong araw at panibagong lesson na ating matututunan dito sa Koday News. At ang bagong lesson natin for today is treating common injuries. So doon sa natin sa una natin naging slide is physical fitness and wellness. So ngayon naman, treating common injuries naman na pwede nating ma-face everyday or simple accidents na pwede nating maranasan for our doing physical fitness activities and how we will treat it. So before we start, we have a great man, great works. And for today's great man, great work is Theodore William Richards. So 1868 to 1928. So Theodore William Richards is American physical chemist. He accurately determined the atomic weights of many chemical elements, among which are oxygen, calcium, zinc, iron, cobalt, barium, and strontium. He also investigated problems on thermodynamics, surface tension, melting and boiling points of liquid. So see, Theodore William Richards ay American physical chemist at siya ay accurately determined. So accurate siya. The atomic weights of many chemical elements like oxygen, calcium, zinc, iron, cobalt, barium, and strontium. Strontium. Oh my gosh, sorry. Strontium. Strontium. He also investigated the problems on thermodynamics, surface tension, and of course, melting and boiling points of liquid. So that's our great man, great works for today. It is Theodore William Richards. He is Theodore William Richards. So dito na tayo sa ating lesson proper na treating common injuries or how we will treat a common accident or little accidents by doing some activities outside or inside our house. So yan. Sometimes during physical fitness activities or in any of your daily activities, somebody else may be injured. Before any adult help arrives, you might need to treat the injury yourself. This first help given to a person who has been injured or suddenly become ill is called first aid. Oh, so ito, here are some ways of treating some common injuries. So yan. So kapag nag-arrive na yung mga nakakatanda, so syempre, as a student, nagkakaroon tayo ng mga lessons about treating common injuries or pagpa-first aid. So kapag alam niyo kung paano i-first aid yung mga little accidents na pwedeng mangyari sa'yo, wag naman sana or sa mga nagkakasama mo by doing some physical activities, tandaan nyo lang itong mga sasabihin ko. And of course, kapag hindi talaga, seek help agad sa mga nakakatanda or sa mga doctors or nurses na may alam how to treat common injuries and mag-apply ng first aid. So, yan. So, for small cuts and scrapes, so wash small cuts and scrapes with soap and water to remove germs. Dry the area and bandage it to keep the wound clean. If the wound continues to bleed, do not remove the first bandage. Put another cloth over it and press. Get help. So pag nagkaroon kayo ng scratch, so or scrapes, small cut, so linis agad ng area ng 'yon. Wash nyo. Maglagay kayo ng sabon, of course. Maglagay kayo ng bandage to keep the wound clean. So, syempre, nahugas kayo. So, yan. So, kapag medyo grabe talaga yung bleeding, huwag niyong tatanggalin daw yung first bandage. So, ang lalagay nyo, put another cloth over it and press. Yung hindi naman kapress na super the end. Yung konting pressure lang. So, yan. Konting pressure lang. So, mag-seek tayo na help para makita kung paano yung gagawin dun sa sugat na yun. So, next. Oops. When person, arm, or leg is injured. So, yan. Keep a person with an injured arm or leg still. Do not move the person. Get help. Pag arm or leg ang na-injure, wag yung gagalawin. Kasi baka may ibang magkaroon ng magalaw mo yung injured part and magkaroon pa ng kaunti pang mas lalo siyang lumala. So, keep the person injured still. Huwag niyo siyang pagagalawin ng sobra kasi baka mas lalong lumala yung condition niya. So, do not move the person, get help. Kapag talaga masakit siya, so get help talaga para makapag-apply ng first aid. And madala siya sa nearest hospital para syempre matreat or magkaroon ng malaman ko pa paano ang gagawin doon sa injured part nung iyong kasama or injured part kapag for may pag may mga small accidents talaga. So yan. When bitten by an insect. If a person has been bitten or stung by an insect, carefully remove the stinger by gently scraping it away. Cover the bite with a cold wet cloth. Tell an adult. So pag nakagat kayo ng isang insect, magsabi kayo sa mga nakakatanda. So yan. Remove the stinger by gently scraping it away. So yan. So maglagay kayo ng cold and wet cloth do sa area na kung saan kayo kinagat ng insect. So after that, tell an adult. Kasi baka kung ano-ano yung mga nakapag-stung sa inyo and baka may masamang effect pa yun and mga baka mamaga or anything, basta magtalkin ng adult soon as possible para makita kung ano yung mangyayari or kung ano yung condition para mapagamot agad. If you burn your skin, run cool water over a burn that does not break the skin or cause blisters. You can also place ice or cold wet cloth directly on the burn. Keep the burn cold until the pain goes away. Get adult help for burn that breaks the skin or cause a blister. So, yan. Pag medyo napaso, run kayo ng water. Pero kapag yung burn ay nag-break sa skin or cause by a blister, so tell an adult. So, yan. If you touch a poisonous plant, if a person gets a rash from touching a poisonous plant, wash the skin with soap and water. Wipe the skin with alcohol and apply calamine lotion. Do not scratch the rash. Scratching will spread the rash. Wash any clothing that might have been rubbed against the plant. So, yan. Wait, next. When bitten by an animal, wash an animal bite with soap and water and dry the skin. If bite is bleeding, press a clean cloth. Oh my god. On the bite until the bleeding stops. Get an adult help. If possible, identify the animal that bit the person. So syempre iba-iba talaga yung effects ng animal bite sa atin. So pag dog talaga kailangan turukan, hugas ng kamay. Linisin siya by alcohol, keep it clean para ma-remove yung mga germs, and of course, seek a doctor. So syempre, alamin nyo kung ano yung nakakagat sa inyo para magkaroon ng treatment. So, may iba-iba kasing treatment yan eh. Depende sa animal na nakakagat sa inyo. So, tell an adult and para makapagkonsultan agad sa doctor and para mabigyan agad kayo ng lunas. So, yan. If blisters form too tight shoes. If a blister forms something rubbing against the skin, cover the blister with bandage. Do not break the blister. If the blister has already been broken, wash the area with soap and water. Dry the area and cover it with a clean bandage. If I'm not mistaken, the Tagalog of blisters is lintog. So pag yung shoes natin is too tight, so nagkakaroon tayo ng blister. So, do not break it. So, medyo may tubig-tubig siya eh. So, ganun yung blister. So, wag na wag mo yung parang ipop-pop. So, pag nag-pop na siya ng kusa, wash mo siya ng sabon and of course, wipe it with a clean cloth. So, yan. Ang ating mga treating common injuries and how we will treat. At mga different types of injuries and how we will treat it. So, thank you. Have a great day and God bless. So, if you like this video, click the thumbs up button and of course leave a comment down below if you have suggestions, clarifications, and suggestions regarding to our recent and future videos. So, thank you, have a great day, and God bless you in my next video. Bye-bye!